Hey Canucks fans, it's game day, and Sven Baertschi has been called up from the Utica Comets. I'm Clay Emo, I'm at Canuck Clay on Twitter, and I'm at Clayton Emo on Instagram. I'm the founder of the GLCPC, the Good Looking Canucks Positivity Club, and this is my Canucks take, all in one take. It's Clay's Canucks commentary for Friday, November the 1st. That's right, the Canucks are in game number 2 of their 3-game California road trip. They're coming off that 5-3 victory over the LA Kings, and now they're playing their toughest match of the 3 games. They're in Anaheim tonight, and they're playing against the Anaheim Ducks. Anaheim is 8-6, so they have 16 points in 14 games. Right behind the Canucks, they have 17 points, but only 12 games. Canucks are at 8-3-1, Anaheim at 8-6. So same number of wins. Canucks have taken 2 fewer games to do so. But if Anaheim wins in regulation, they will jump over the Canucks in the tight Pacific Division standings. Couple things I want to talk about really quickly. Number one, kind of cool, the Canucks came out and they jumped on this whole team like that slogan, the team like that phase. Of course, that phrase that came from when Drew Doughty was talking after the Canucks first beat the Kings, Canucks home opener way back on October 9, they demolished the Kings 8-2, and Drew Doughty said something like, a team like that should not be beating a team like ours 8-2. Well, it was motivation, it was bulletin board material, as Bo Horvat admitted. And sure enough, the day after the game, after the Canucks beat them once again, 5-3 this time in LA, the Canucks released shirts saying, team like that. I took a picture with my dog, Mickey, in front of our Canucks banner at home, saying, dog like that. I'm sure there's going to be a lot of other parodies, a lot of memes, whatever it may be. I'm actually thinking about doing a song, but we'll see. I had a couple options that I'm toying around. But regardless, it's really cool that the Vancouver Canucks have jumped on it. Kind of like the Bunch of Jerks things inspired by Don Cherry for the Carolina Hurricanes last year. And that propelled them to a Stanley Cup run. at least a run through the playoffs. They didn't make the Stanley Cup Finals, but they made it through a couple rounds. Will something like this be a galvanizing force, a kind of a rallying cry? And even the Canucks don't progress that far. Maybe even if they don't make it to the playoffs, at least it's a lot of fun, and it's something for the fans to kind of get around, just like Shotgun Jake and now a team like that. And I didn't just say that the Canucks won't make the playoffs. I do think they have a very good chance of making the playoffs, especially with their hot start. So that's that. Pretty cool. Today I want to talk about the call-up of Sven Baertschi. Now, the two aspects I want to talk about. I want to talk about the circumstances that sent him down and whether you thought that was right. And then I want to talk about going forward, what this means for him and the implications on the Canucks lineup. So we know that Sven Baertschi was sent down after a decent preseason. It wasn't amazing, but it was pretty good. He got sent down when the season started, along with Nikolai Godobin, cleared waivers, and then was sent down to the Utica Comets. And then the Canucks obviously were off to their hot start with their 17 points in their 12 games. And there were certainly a few people who didn't like the move when it happened. They thought that the Canucks needed his package of skill and of speed and goal scoring. But, of course, as the Canucks got better and better, and as they continued to ascend the standings with their hot start, fewer and fewer people talked about the Canucks missing Sven Baertschi. And which makes sense, right? But at the time, there were a lot of people that were upset because they finally, it's almost like talking in terms of the Canucks betraying Baertschi after he worked so hard to come back from that really tough concussion last season, how he just had a new child in the family. So all these personal things also playing into a role in people being upset that he got sent down. And I get that. Then Sven Baertschi, he clears waivers. So was that a justification, or was that a sign that other teams didn't also see him? And the Canucks basically wanted to get more comfortable, more confident. At least that's the terms they used. And at the time, I didn't really doubt it. Like I felt bad for him as a person, but I also usually I have confidence in Benning and in Green, and that they're molding the lineup how they wanted to in order to give them the best chance to win. Sven Baertschi goes down as a true pro, racks up 10 points in 7 games, really, really good, and that's what you'd expect, a legit NHL player dominating AHL action. And sure enough, just after 10 games in Utica, after 1 month of the season, 12 games for the Canucks, Sven Baertschi has been called up to the big club. So that's my first question for you, Canucks fans. Were you upset when the Canucks sent him down at the start of October, right before the season started, or did you think it was a good move for him or for the club at the time? And let's try not to look in hindsight. Let's try not to look at the fact that the Canucks have started off so well, although I think that naturally plays a part in our thinking. Were you upset at the time, or were you accepted were you acceptable at the time? I know the general sense was when the Canucks sent him down, people were outraged. When they put him on waivers, Canucks, most fans were outraged. But then once he cleared waivers, they're like, okay, well, maybe this isn't such a bad move after all. Maybe the Canucks do know what they're doing. Now, I get it. There are a lot of guys going through waivers the day before, you know, the rosters have to be finalized. So maybe he got lost in the shuffle, or just maybe other GMs weren't willing to take a risk. But now he's up. And it looks like he'll likely stay up for a while, depending on what happens. Tyler Mott out for a couple weeks. Antoine Roussel still hurt. And now we're waiting to hear news on Michael Ferland. He got hurt in that fight, or right after that fight, probably during that fight with Kyle Clifford against LA on Wednesday night. And we haven't heard speculation that's concussion related, but that's speculation. It could be a hand, you know, whether it's a hand on Clifford's helmet or shoulder pads or whatever it may be. You can obviously hurt your hand when you're fighting. Could be a shoulder. It could be an elbow. Who knows what it could be. So we'll wait till we hear official word. But the fact that he's going to be out for a while means the Canucks need another forward. So now we have Adam Gaudette and Sven Baertschi as our extra forwards, as number 12 and number 13. Which guy is going to get in? It sounds like if Sven Baertschi has travel problems, which sounds like it might be the case today, that it could be Adam Gaudette today, and then we'll see where he plays. That'll be interesting to know. I'm recording this before the game day skate. And then if Sven Baertschi doesn't make it, then maybe Sven Baertschi gets in tomorrow. So we can talk about lineups. You know, I may record a video later once they release the lineups. I may not. But with Adam Gaudette, does he play third line center? Does that move Brandon Sutter to a wing? Does Gaudette play on the wing? I have a sense to put Gaudette in the center and then put Sutter on the wing, and then maybe play them together. That's what Travis Green likes to do. And that would mean, in essence, Gaudette slides in for Ferland's spot on the third line. Then you don't have to touch Schaller, Beagle, and Erickson on the fourth line. It would just be a matter of who's playing center, Gaudette or Sutter. Sutter will probably take draws, and Gaudette likely will play center, though, once the play gets going. So that's my guess for today, but we'll see in a couple hours. Then when Sven Baertschi gets here, whether today or likely tomorrow, what happens there? Who comes out? Is it Gaudette comes back out? That's kind of weird, right? Why do you bring him up to sit him every second game or two out of every three games? Does Louis Eriksson come out? Well, he's just getting his feet under him once again. Or is it a guy like Schaller or Leivel? I don't know. The Canucks have been ticking quite well, so it's tough to say. So I think the really interesting thing will be, where will Sven Baertschi play? Who we play with? Or maybe do you bump him up because of a skilled guy? Maybe put him up in the second line with, say, like Horvat and Virtanen, and you move Pearson down to the third line, or Horvat and Pearson, and you move Virtanen down the third line. So there's a lot of things that you can do when Sven Baertschi comes in, but, you know, I'll try and record a video once we know what the lineup's going to look like. But it's fun to speculate, of course. So that's the second question is, who would you play Sven Baertschi with once he gets in the lineup, whether it's tonight or likely more tomorrow night? I think he's got to be a second liner as opposed to a third liner. So I see him with Horvat. He's had good chemistry with him before. And then you choose either one of Pearson or Virtanen, and you drop the other one. Likely you keep Virtanen there. You maybe drop Pearson to the third line. So we'll see about that. And then I guess the other factor is, now that Sven Baertschi is up, he did really well in Utica. Once everyone gets healthy again, it's going to be a lot harder to send Sven Baertschi down to Utica, because I think now this time you're not going to get him through waivers. Another GM's going to claim him if even you put him on waivers. So is this a sign that Sven Baertschi is up for the rest of the season and the Canucks will have to make decisions on other guys? Gaudette can, for the next few games, can still be sent up and down, or maybe another move is in the works. So a lot of fascinating things to think about with this call-up of Sven Baertschi. But three questions really for you. Does it right or wrong, or were you okay with sending him down in the first place? Number two, who's he going to play with? And number three, do you agree with me that this means that he'll be here to stay and the Canucks will be forced into other roster decisions as guys get healthy? Mott, Ferland, and of course, Roussel in a few weeks as well. So a lot of cool things to think about. I won't be watching the game tonight. I'm actually emceeing an event, a charity event, where proceeds are going to Canuck Place, which is kind of cool. So at least there's a Canucks angle there. But, I'll be following up on Twitter, of course, and then going home and watching the game on the PVR, presuming that it's worth watching, which I presume it will be. All right, so lots to talk about. Would love to know your thoughts on the Sven Baertschi call-up as we continue to cheer on a team like that. Leave a comment below. Love to read, react, reply. Subscribe if you'd like to. Like this video if you'd like to. Enjoy the day. God bless. Go Canucks go.